This morning by Mr. Bonner Dytoc, co-founder of Absolute Traders. Good morning, sir.
Morning, Warren.
How do you like that news?
Well, that's quite surprising, actually.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now moving on to our Market 101 segment. Today we're talking about trading strategies in a bull market.
Yes.
So, sir, what are the strategies that investors can use in a bull market?
Well, actually, there are a lot of strategies that many traders can use, but let's concentrate on the more popular ones. First one is what a lot of people would like to call value investing. And by this, they would then go into some fundamental analysis. They'll take a look at the books of the company, they'll take a look at the income statement, and then they'll probably get a certain valuation of how the company should be. And then when they take a look at the market price, they can now get an idea for themselves if the price is currently at a discount to that valuation or not. And as far as we know, the biggest proponent of value investing is the Oracle of Omaha, mm-hmm. Warren Buffett.
Right.
So the last transaction that I know that he got into was Bank of America. Mm-hmm. And I know that he used this kind of strategy. Mm-hmm. Now, there are also others that you can use, but this one now lies more into technical trading.
Okay.
So when we're talking about technical trading, we're talking more about how we are going to trade certain stocks based on what we see on the chart.
Mm-hmm.
So the first kind would be range trading. So based on what we've seen on a particular chart, there could be a certain range that the stock price could be moving at, and then there would be a certain idea, like it would probably go down to a bottom of, say, for example, this particular stock would be at 1 peso, and that would more or less be where the bottom would be, and then there would be a lot of people who'd be buying at that price. And then seeing that there would be a lot of selling pressure at a higher price, probably at around 120, 130, these same people who bought near the bottom would now be posting their sellings or try to sell at that area also.
Mm-hmm.
So they're trying to trade the range. Another kind of trading style that you can use would be day trading. Day trading actually is a little harder for those who are quite familiar with value investing and range trading, because this one would put a little more pressure on you. You would need to close your transaction within the day. So you'd need to get in and out at the same day. As far as I know, a lot of day traders would try to get net profit of around 3 to 5% within the day to satisfy their requirements.
I have a question about that. The longer trading hours this year, mm-hmm. You have a morning session and an afternoon session.
Yes.
That technically should make it easier for you to do day trading.
Not necessarily, because sometimes you just could not predict where the next movement would be, wherein you would think that there would be a rise in the price right now, and you would be buying, and then you would wait for your 3 to 5% within the day, and it so happens that things turn around. So much like what I just discussed, any kind of trading strategy, you need to set a cut loss point. Mm-hmm. That's very important.
Right. So these are technical, based on technical analysis.
Yes.
But a lot of our first-time investors usually do not subscribe to technical analysis because of their inexperience with trading the market.
True.
So how do you go about value investing? What are the points do you look at if you're new to the market?
Well, first of all, I think what they would need to know is that based on the valuations given to them, first of all, they would like to take a look at the PE. Would the PE ratio for this company currently be at a discount to the market's PE ratio?
Mm-hmm.
Would it be at a discount to the sector's PE ratio? So that would be one of the factors to take a look at in value investing. On the other hand, you also try to take a look at how are the current projects going to contribute to its bottom line.
Mm-hmm.
Will it contribute to projected earnings of X percent increase? So if they see that the price currently is quite sensible, given that there is a big future for this company, they would try to get into it probably at the current price.
Right. basically what you're doing is you're looking for stocks that you would like based on their fundamentals, their earnings, yes, and their true market value. Mm-hmm. And obviously, since as you mentioned earlier, a big proponent of this is Warren Buffett,
yes,
and he's been very successful using this kind of value investing. Mm-hmm. And of course, he's one of the world's richest men. So which would you suggest then to our viewers to use in a bull market, a value investing or the technical trading where you have range trading, day trading, and momentum trading?
Oh yes, momentum trading. This is one thing that actually I use for myself. This is another kind of technical trading wherein I try to go with the flow of how the stock is going. Mm-hmm. On the day when the price moves quite high with a lot of volume that's accompanying it, that's the time for me to start getting into it. And then I try to wait until the target based on the chart has been met. Mm-hmm. But back to your question, right now we are in a bull market. What can I suggest to our viewers? Well, first of all, especially for the new investors, the first thing that you need to do is to educate yourself. And by that, you have a lot of information these days that you can get from the newspaper, from your friends, from the internet. Unfortunately, we have a very low accuracy as far as filtering out all the details as to which one is accurate and which one is not. So my suggestion would be, it would be best for you to go through the seminars being offered by a lot of these other institutions, which also includes my own company that offers these kinds of seminars.
Right. When do you hold your seminar, sir?
Well, we have on Thursday, well, that's today, we start a new batch in our office at Shaw Boulevard. And then on Tuesdays, we also have another batch for those who are in Makati.
All right. Lastly, sir, you mentioned earlier we are in a bull market. What is your technical outlook for the PSEI and the market right now? Right now we're at 47.95, actually in the red, about 0.25%.
Oh, that's all right, because as far as the chart is telling me, I am predicting that the PSE can still go up to around 5,400.
5,400?
Yes.
That's year end?
Could be year end. Well, hopefully things stay as they are, but we know it won't.
Look, some of the other analysts we've spoken to said 5,000 by the end of February. Do you think that's still feasible?
Well, it remains to be seen.
All right, okay. Well, thank you very much for your time this morning.
All right, thank you.
That's Mr. Bonner D.